Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video, we will make this cool and tiny Wi-Fi jammer. It is so tiny that you can carry this Wi-Fi jammer in your pocket. Although it is illegal to jam someone's Wi-Fi network, but I will be testing this Wi-Fi jammer on my own Wi-Fi network, so I don't have any problem. But don't try this Wi-Fi jammer on someone's Wi-Fi network. You can face legal charges. Before proceeding, if you are new to my channel, make sure to subscribe to my channel and don't forget to press that bell icon. So to make this Wi-Fi jammer, you need this module which is called ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. It is like Arduino microcontroller which can be programmed using computer. But the benefit is that it has inbuilt Wi-Fi module which can be used to connect to the Wi-Fi network. Or in this video, we will be using this Wi-Fi module to create interference in the Wi-Fi network area or jamming the Wi-Fi network area. The other components which you require are optional. Optional in the sense that if you want to make this Wi-Fi jammer compact or easy to carry, you can use this component. But if you want to use power bank or mobile charger, you don't need these components. The components you need to make it compact is this lithium polymer battery, this boost converter. I will give link to this boost converter in the video description. You can buy from that link. And you need this one small toggle switch to turn the Wi-Fi jammer on or off. First, we will program the ESP8266 using the computer. Please follow all the steps carefully. If you skip any step, the Wi-Fi jammer will not work and you will say that it is fake. So follow all the steps carefully. So let's program it. Open your browser, search Arduino IDE, click on software, scroll down, select your OS and another software. I will cancel it because I already have the software. Then download the zip file, link is in video description. After downloading the zip file, you have to extract it. You will see YPWN master. Open that. Open Arduino in the YPWN master folder. Then go to YPWN and open YPWN with Arduino. Now go to tools and select your board. If you don't see your board here, go to board manager and search ESP8266 here. If you don't see the result here, go to files, preference and paste the URL here. I will give the URL in the description. And go to board manager again, search ESP8266. This time you have result. Select 2.0.0 and install it. It is very important to install 2.0.0, otherwise the jammer will not work. After installing these boards, we will copy and delete some files. Now we have the boards. Go to files and preferences and go to this directory. Now go to packages, hardware, ESP8266 2.0, tools, SDK, include, and you have to delete user these files. Now go to SDK fix, copy this file and paste to this folder again, the folder from which we have deleted this file. Now go back. Open this, go to libraries, then go to ESP Wi-Fi source and you have to copy paste these two remaining files in this folder. We will copy and replace these files. Now we are ready to upload the code. Open Arduino, go to tools, select your board. As I am using NodeMCU, I will select NodeMCU. Select the CPU frequency, then port. And click on upload. The code will start uploading on your NodeMCU or your ESP. Now we are done with the programming. Now we will make this Wi-Fi jammer compact. First we will connect the lithium polymer battery to the boost converter, which will boost 3.7 volt to the 5 volt. Then we will give 5 volt to the Wi-Fi module, but we will connect the switch between boost converter and ESP8266 so that we can turn it off when we don't need the Wi-Fi jammer. Let's build this. Now I have connected some wires on the boost converter. I will connect this purple wire to the V and blue to the ground. I will be connecting the switch here like this. I have connected the switch here to the positive 5 volt, and this is the another end. You have to connect this wire first to this point and then to the ground. Now we are done with the power supply. I have connected the boost converter with the battery, and this is the wire which you have to connect to the Wi-Fi module. I will connect this purple to V in and ground with the blue wire. Always check the polarity first before connecting the or before turning the circuit on. Now I have connected this whole circuit together. Let's find out whether it is working or not. I have pressed this button. You see, the boost converter is now on, and now it's time to jam some Wi-Fi's. First I have connected the battery with the double side tape, then I have folded GPIO pins on the battery so the battery is going nowhere. I have placed double side tape on the boost converter. It will secure the boost converter, and moreover it will protect the boost converter from the GPIO pins of the microcontroller, because if they will short with each other, it can burn your microcontroller. This is the switch which I have connected with the boost converter. Luckily, the boost converter which we are using, it has built-in charging circuit. Now you can see the light is blinking. It means that the battery is charging. So I will disconnect it and I will turn this Wi-Fi jammer on with this click over button. Now your Wi-Fi jammer is on, the light is glowing. I will open my phone Wi-Fi setting. You will see Wi-Fi PWM on the Wi-Fi. Connect to that Wi-Fi, and after connecting, open your browser and go to 192.168.4.1. After connecting to the IP address, you will be asked that whether you are in this the device for penetration testing. Agree with it, and then you will be asked to set SSID and password. Set the your desired SSID or password. After setting this password and SSID, your Wi-Fi jammer will reboot. After rebooting, you will see a SSID which you have set earlier. Connect to that Wi-Fi SSID. As I have set the SSID hacker, I will connect to that. So open this IP address again. You will see this Wi-Fi. Just scan here. So as my home Wi-Fi is connect, I will select this, and you can check the number of users connected to this Wi-Fi devices. But I will not check because it will show my MAC address. I don't want to reveal my MAC address. So then go to attack. You can see different attack type. DAUT. Deauthentication means it will disconnect all the connected devices which are connected to the Wi-Fi network, or you can particular single device by selecting it from user tab. So this is a beacon tab. Beacon tab means it will set the number of random Wi-Fi. Start the tag. I will open the Wi-Fi setting. You will see more and more Wi-Fi will start showing up. This will be a very annoying to a person who is trying to connect it to its home network. So now I will go back to my hacking portal. I will turn it off and click random. It will create random SSID, and that's it. When you will click the authentication, it will disconnect all the devices. This is the main attack. It will jam all the Wi-Fi protocol and you will not be able to connect to your network. The authentication attack work on interference. Consider this is a sine wave. And actually this is not a very good example because the Wi-Fi signal is digital signal, but the sine wave is analog signal. But I will give you this example. This is how the noise cancellation or interference work. Consider this as a sine wave, and as this is a one cycle, so when I will press the authentication, the Wi-Fi jammer will create a sine wave inverse to the your Wi-Fi network. So the resultant will be zero. So you will not be able to connect to your network because there is no signal. So this is how the Wi-Fi jammer works. This code needs some more improvement, so stay tuned to my channel for the improved version by subscribing to my channel. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Please like, share and comment and tell me what you would like to see in my next upcoming video. Thank you so much for watching my video.